Hey, what's up? Good to see all of you again. Now, what are we going to do? We're going to learn how to solve inequality problems. Now, what does the term inequality mean? Notice on the left side, how many balls do you see? Three balls. And on the right side, how many balls are there? Two balls. This amount here on the left is greater than, that's a greater than symbol there, than this amount here on the right. Three balls are greater than two balls. This amount is not equal to this amount. What does the word inequality mean? It means not equal. This is a math sentence. It means 3 is greater than 2. Yeah, that's what it means. This is an English sentence. What does this mean? Well, it also means 3 is greater than 2. Both of these sentences mean the same thing. On the top here, we've got an inequality problem, and we're using pictures to demonstrate it. Three balls here are greater than two balls. Now we're going to solve a basic inequality problem. X plus 2 is less than 7. Again, X plus 2 is less than 7. How do we solve it? What are we going to do? We're going to have to isolate X. Where is the X? Is it on the right side? Nope. Is it on the left side? Yes. The X and the 2, how are they connected? What operation connects the X with the 2? Let's think. There's addition, subtraction, multiplication, and there's division. Which of the 4 is it? Right, addition. Addition. How do we isolate X? We've got to do the opposite of addition. What's the opposite of addition? Subtraction. We have to subtract 2. Seven minus 2 equals 5. And what is 2 minus 2 equal? 0. And we just bring down the X. The less than symbol also comes down. And so what is our answer? X is less than 5. Now we're going to show the answer on the number line. Here's our number line. What are we going to do? First, we got to find a number. Well, what number do we find? Ah, this one right here, 5. Where is the 5? There we go. Second, we draw a circle. The circle, well, what exactly does the circle mean? It means 5 is not in the answer. Remember, the answer is X is less than 5. 5 is not less than 5. That means 5 is not in the answer. Third, we draw a line showing all the numbers in the answer. Try different numbers and maybe start with 7. Is 7 less than 5? Nope. Is 6 less than 5? Nope. Is 5 less than 5? No. 5 is equal to 5. 5 is not less than 5. Is 4 less than 5? Yes. Is 3 less than 5? Yes. Are 2, 1, 0, negative 1, and continue on into much smaller numbers, all less than 5? Yes. Now the number line shows all numbers less than 5. And we're done. Now suppose the inequality problem changes just a little bit. X plus 2 is less than 7 becomes X plus 2 is less than or equal to 7. Again, X plus 2 less than or equal to 7. What are we going to do? How do we solve this? It's almost the same process. We'll want to isolate X. Notice that on the left side, you see an X and a 2. How are they connected? Addition. What are we going to do? We must do the opposite. We must subtract. Seven minus two equals 5. Next, the less than or equal sign comes down. And 2 minus 2 equals 0. 2 minus 2 equals 0. The x comes down. 2 minus 2 equals 0. And our answer is x is less than or equal to 5. Now, how are we going to show this on the number line? It's almost the same process. First, we've got to find a number. Well, which number are we going to find? 5. There's the 5. Next, we're going to draw a circle. But the circle must be shaded in. Why does a circle need to be shaded in? Remember, the answer is x is less than or equal to 5. That means that the x can be equal to 5, and that means the 5's in the answer. The circle must be shaded. Third, you got to draw a line showing all the numbers in the answer. Try different numbers. Start with 7. Is 7 less than or equal to 5? Nope. Is 6 less than or equal to 5? Nope. Is 5 less than or equal to 5? Yes. That means that 5 is in the answer. Is 4 less than or equal to 5? Yes. Are 3, 2, 1, 0, and negative 1 all less than or equal to 5? Yes. Now, the number line shows all numbers in the answer. And we're done. Now suppose we have a little bit different problem. X plus 2 is greater than 5. How do we solve it? What are we going to do? We're going to have to isolate X. Notice on the left side, there's an X and a 2. What operation connects them? Addition. How are we going to isolate the x? We're going to have to do the opposite operation. We're going to have to subtract. Two minus two equals zero. The x we just bring right down. The greater than symbol we also bring down. And then five minus two equals three. So our answer is x is greater than 3, and we're done. Now, suppose the problem's a little bit different. X is greater than 3 becomes x is greater than or equal to 3. How does the number line change? Right. The circle becomes shaded. Why is that? Remember, what is our answer? X is greater than or equal to 3. That means that 3 is in the answer. The circle right there must be shaded. Now, the number line shows all numbers that are equal to 3 or greater than 3. And we're finished.
Thank you for watching. Now, watch more math videos.